Ian Lee, CBS News.
A Pasadena-based church that filed a lawsuit to hold indoor service during the COVID-19 pandemic says it will appeal to the U.S. Supreme Court. After a split decision in its latest legal action, Harvest Rock Church can hold services while the lawsuit is decided, and followers will be able to meet indoors with up to 200 people in counties in the less restrictive red and orange tiers, but they cannot meet within counties in the purple tier where the virus is more widespread. That includes Los Angeles County. And a Santa Clarita man accused of defrauding the federal government out of more than $650,000 in COVID-19 relief funds, pleading guilty, Raymond McGanna admitted in the virtual courtroom that he applied for the Paycheck Protection Program loans using false information, along with a partner who pleaded guilty last month. Prosecutors say the two men together took out $2.5 million in loans from different banks. McGanna is due to be sentenced in May. President Biden signing executive orders today to try to stop racism. We've got a special report from CBS Network News coming up at the bottom of the hour at 11:30. Right now it is 11:25, sponsored by Land Rover. Your traffic and weather together every 10 minutes on the fives. Here's Tom Tran.
Northbound side of the Golden State Freeway. A little bit of slowing over near Dodger Stadium. It's already starting to clear out. Looks like there's debris in the roadway getting in your way. The other problem on the Golden State Freeway, heading up to the Grapevine. And the fives basically shut down from Hasley Canyon all the way up towards the Fort Mount area. Well, past 138 because of the snow. And slick conditions just like yesterday. We're going to keep an eye on this because it changes moment to moment. But you can't get up towards the Bakersfield area from the 5. I actually got a phone call about it this morning from a friend who was heading up there wanting to know why the 101 was being suggested to get up to Bakersfield. It's because the 5 is shut down. We did have an earlier problem on the 405 going northbound down through Fountain Valley. Caltrans work getting into life projects here as traffic should be Warner heading up towards the beach. Boatman's not a terrible delay. And that earlier crash on the westbound side of the 10 San Bernardino Freeway still causing a slowdown from Cherry over towards Etowah Avenue. A couple vehicles involved in this crash. Clears up by the time you get to the 15. Introducing the 2020 Land Rover Defender Motor Trend's 2021 SUV of the Year. Defender's capabilities to the test at your local SoCal Land Rover retailer today. Land Rover, above and beyond. Your next report, 11:35. More traffic reports, more often. Tom Trend, video at audiocenter.com. Traffic there. KNX 770 News Radio. Sunny, cold today, windy in some areas as well. It's the calm before yet another storm system heading our way. Highs in the mid to upper 50s tonight, partly to mostly cloudy skies, overnight lows in the 40s. And then tomorrow, clouds, chance of rain is yet another storm system, the third in 7 days to move in. Highs again in the mid to upper 50s. The storm system moving in tomorrow will be with us for the next few days, clearing out by Saturday. Do have a high surf advisory with us for Los Angeles and Orange County coastal areas until 6 p.m. this evening. Right now it is 56. 6 degrees in downtown Los Angeles. Coming up at the bottom of the hour, President Biden signing a series of executive actions dealing with racism. We've been in-depth coverage, a special report from CBS Network News just 3 minutes away. It's 11:27.
Hey, it's Mike Simpson here. If you have loose or missing teeth, you cover your mouth when you talk or you smile. You don't want people to see, or you're dealing with the pain, the drama, the embarrassment. From losing teeth, Cunning Dental wants to make your 2021 a whole lot better with new permanent teeth and a beautiful smile. A perfect smile. It's their teeth in one day procedure. It gives you beautiful teeth that look 100% natural, custom made for you. And then you can bite and chew just like you used to. Eat all your favorite foods again. Be proud to smile in photos. Talk and socialize like you used to when we're back to socializing more. Every day, you get the confidence back. This procedure is done while you sleep. It's easy. You wake up with new beautiful teeth. Imagine that. Perfect teeth for 2021. It's going to make your year. Get a $1,000 gift voucher on new permanent teeth. This is through February 28th. Some restrictions apply. Give them a call, 855-2-CUNNING, 855-2-CUNNING. The before and after videos at cunningdental.com. Everybody says, why didn't I do this sooner? 855-2-CUNNING. They've been making smiles great since 1968.
On the battlefield, there's a saying America's military men and women live by. Never leave a fallen warrior behind, ever. Off the battlefield, Wounded Warrior Project operates with the same goal. Wounded Warrior Project was created to help our men and women returning home with the scars of war, whether those scars are physical or mental. Wounded Warrior Project, we never leave a fallen warrior behind, ever. Learn more about what we do at woundedwarriorproject.org.
Napa know-how.
Getting $20 back when you buy a Napa Legend premium battery is a win-win. Getting it from the best car people around is a win-win-win. Getting it before you're stranded somewhere, that's a win-win-win. battery. And that sounds like a lot of wins. You're right. Quality parts and helpful people. That's Napa know-how.
Napa know-how.
And participating Napa Auto Parts stores and Napa Auto Care Centers. While supplies last. Offer ends 2/28/21.
Does it feel like finding clothes in your fit is impossible? Tired of feeling overwhelmed with options that just aren't right? Let the experts at Stitch Fix do the shopping for you. At Stitch Fix, we make sure each piece is hand-selected for your life. So whether you're staying home or on the go, Stitch Fix is the answer for what to wear. We make it easy to find what works for you. Signing up takes just a few minutes, and styles are delivered directly to your door. Get started today at stitchfix.com. Stitch Fix, your style delivered.
Omnifund, NMLS 4869. VRE license 0143-0833. Tom Brown's NMLS 36860. VRE 0178975. Borrowers must qualify. Minimum loan amount $250,000. APR below 2.5%. 680 credit score and 10% VA disability.
Veterans, Tom Brown here. And today I'm offering 1.99% 30-year fixed VA streamline refinance. You heard me. 1.99% 30-year fixed VA streamline refinance. Call 844-949-5600 because I don't just serve veterans. I am one.
If you're tired of struggling with business, mortgage, or credit card debt, go to oaktreelaw.com. That's oaktreelaw.com.
This is Southern California's only 24-hour local news and traffic station, KNX 1070 News Radio. President Biden signing a series of executive actions revolving around racial equity policy. We have in-depth team coverage, the latest now, at 11:31.
CBS News Special Report. President Biden is outlining his racial equity agenda and is right now signing executive actions at the White House.
I believe this nation and this government need to change our whole approach to the issue of racial equity. Yes. We need criminal justice reform. That isn't nearly enough.
The president's using his authority to disavow racism and xenophobia toward Asian Americans, specifically targeting anti-Asian connected to the COVID-19 pandemic.
Time to act now, not only because it's the right thing to do, but because if we do, we'll all be better off for it.
CBS's Bo Erickson. The executive order rejects racially charged terms like China virus and Kung Flu to describe the pandemic's origin and targets better information for Asian American communities regarding COVID-19. Other upcoming administrative actions are expected to be focused on tribal governments, fair housing, and private prisons. CBS News Special Report. I'm Matt Piper.
11:32 on KNX. President Biden also expected to update his administration's efforts to distribute and administer the coronavirus vaccine. This comes as some states have had to temporarily shut down their vaccination sites as part of their exhausted supply. White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki says Mr. Biden did not misspeak when he alluded to ramping up vaccinations to 1.5 million doses a day after initially pushing for just 1 million a day.
Our concern and our focus is not just on the supply. That's part of the issue. It is also about ensuring that states have the number of vaccinators they need. So that means people who are literally taking the shots and qualified to put them in the arms of Americans.
She says it's still not clear what the state of vaccinations is because the previous administration did not have a federal plan put in place. California revamping its vaccine delivery system to give the state more control over who gets the shots following intense criticism of a slow and scattered rollout by counties. The state's health agency says third-party administrators will take over ordering and distributing vaccine doses. Health officials say that will put an end to hodgepodge systems currently in place where each county and hospital system ran its own vaccine delivery program. The move comes after much criticism over the state's slow rollout. California's new coronavirus figures have just been released. The state now reporting there have been more than 17,000 new cases over the last 24 hours. That continues a steady drop in cases by more than half that amount from 2 weeks ago. Meanwhile, 409 more people have died, bringing the state's death toll from COVID-19 to more than 37,000. The statewide positivity rate is at just over 9%. Los Angeles Police Chief Michael Moore saying today that 8 department employees are currently hospitalized with COVID-19, and he says 3 of them are in very critical condition. Just yesterday, the chief announced that a 25-year veteran officer from the department died of complications from COVID. Officer Philip Sudario was assigned to the Southeast Community Police Station in South Los Angeles. He was the 4th LAPD officer and 6th department employee to die from COVID-19. It's 11:34. The one high school sport can start up again now that Governor Newsom has lifted the state stay-at-home orders. That sport is cross-country. It qualifies because CIF labeled it as Season 1 sport.
and it meets, can be held under the county's purple tier because cross country is considered a low contact sport.
And there was this big question with schools, particularly public schools, would they allow sports to happen while they're still in distance learning? There were some questions, you know, if kids aren't on campus, then you can't do sports. It appears that most of them now are going to allow that to happen.
Southern California News Group High School sports reporter Fred Robledo tells KNX there are also plans to start up baseball and softball in the springtime, but he says it's still unclear if football or basketball will be allowed to start anytime soon. He says that will depend on if the state officials will allow it. Kobe Bryant, honored today by fans at Staples Center 1 year to the day after his death in that tragic helicopter crash. We've been to have team coverage coming up right after traffic in 2 minutes. It's 11:35. Traffic and weather together every 10 minutes on the fives. We check in again with Tom Tran.
We still have some slowing over on the San Bernardino Freeway. That westbound 10, there was an earlier accident just before the 15. You can see a little bit of slowing start back near Cherry. They just need to get past Etiwanda Avenue. So it's like one exit for them slowing. By the time you get to the 15, things start to clear up. You can see a little bit of road work slowing on that 10 as you approach 4th Street.